Hi, my name is George Ortiz, aka Jorge Ortiz, aka George Ortiz, and this is my last lecture. So the first topic that I like to talk about is my parents, what they mean to me, and how they helped me in the present day. My parents met at the age of 18, they fell in love, got married, and they had me. You know, all that lovey-gushy, soft stuff. So anyways, my father and my mother came to this country as illegal immigrants, and they had to fight for everything that they had. And they told me that they didn't come to this country for me to slack off and go down the wrong path. So I feel like it's my job to make them proud and accomplish a lot of things for them. At a young age, they instilled in me that the only way I was going to be successful in life was if I worked hard at everything I did. And not a day goes by where I don't think of those words. It's kind of like my motto. My father and my mother have sacrificed everything for me, and now it's my turn to put my side of the work and help them and provide for them. Even though we have our arguments, I'm always grateful to have loving parents that will never leave my side when things get difficult or rough. So, yeah. Two words to describe my parents would be hardworking and extremely loving. We getting it and we gon' make it, and they gon' hate it, and I'm his favorite. I can't deny it, I'm a straight rider, but when we get together, be electric sliding. Grandma, get them shook up, oh no, don't open the photo book up. I got a Aunt Ruth that can't remember your name, but I bet them Polaroids will send her down memory lane. You know that one auntie, you don't mean to be rude, but every holiday nobody eating a food. And you don't wanna stay there, cause them your worst cousins. Got roaches at they crib like them your first cousins. Cousins. Act like you ain't took a bath with your cousin. Fit three in the bed. If it's 60, y'all, I'm talking about three by the head and three by the leg. But you ain't have to tell my girl I used to pee in the bed. Rain, 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 go away. Yeah. Let the sun come out and all the children say. Rain, 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 go away. Yeah. A creative way to rhyme without using knives and guns. Keep your nose out the sky, keep your heart to God, and keep your face to the rise. All right, so for my second topic, I'm going to be talking about my friends and the person that is near and dear to my heart. And you guys know who you are. Anyways, these are the type of friends that you would do anything for. They will forever have a special place in my heart, and I'm very grateful for them. Almost all of them have known me since junior high, because we were all new kids and we couldn't find our classes. Those years were made into some of the best years of my life thanks to them. We were constantly competing with everything. We competed with our grades to see who was better, and we did the same thing with sports. We pushed each other each and every day, and we always tested our limits to see who was the best. I mean, sure, you would get mad at them from time to time, but in the end, they're like a second family to you. All of these people have taught me something very important in life, and they've helped me at one point during my life. You know, that's something that can't be replaced. We laugh together, we cry together, and we work hard together. And if you're watching this right now, before everyone else is, and you're on the slide, it means you're very special in some shape or form.
How's your son? All the he made the team this year? He said he wasn't tall enough.
All the glitter
is not gold.
Nah, yeah, we're gonna cook this son.
Reality.
This is family business, and this is for the family that can't be with us. And this is for my cousin locked down, all the answers in us. This is why I spit it in my song, so sweet like a photo where your granny's pitching out that you're gone and hit us. Super hard on Thanksgiving and Christmas, this can't be right. Yeah, you heard the track I did, man, this can't be life. Somebody please say grace so I can save face and have a reason to cover my face. I even made you a plate, soul food, know how granny do it. Monkey bread on the side, know how the family do it. When I brought her, why the car had to look all through it? As kids, we used to laugh. Who knew that life would move this fast? Who knew I have to look at you through a glass? And look, you tell me you ain't did it, then you ain't did it. And if you did, then that's family business.
Hey! Oh,
yeah. When they ain't believe in me, now she like, see, that's my cousin on TV. Now, we getting it and we gon' make it, and they gon' hate it, and I'm his favorite. I can't deny it, I'm a straight rider, but when we get together, be electric sliding. Grandma, get them shook up. Oh, no, nah, don't open the photo book up. I got a Aunt Ruth. Okay.
Hey.
Ooh!
You don't wanna stay there, cause them your worst cousins. Got roaches at they crib like them your first cousins. Act like you ain't took a bath with your cousin. Fit three in the bed. If it's six of y'all, I'm talking about three by the head and three by the leg. But you ain't have to tell my girl I used to pee in the bed.
Yeah.
And guns, keep your nose out the sky, keep your heart to God, and keep your face to the rise.
Yeah, with you.
Yeah.
Hey.
He used to crawl around. Yeah.
Still love your man and be manly, dog. You ain't gotta get heated at every housewarming. Sitting here grilling people like George Foreman.
Alright, so if you guys have been paying attention, or you guys haven't felt the need to leave the classroom yet, because you're cringing hard. This is the third topic and the final topic, and it's going to be about soccer. So at a very young age, I didn't really have a lot of friends because I was considered weird, but the friends I had were because of soccer. I grew up idolizing Lionel Messi, as many kids my age still do. I wanted to be like him and play professional soccer. I wore his jersey to school a lot, and eventually I was made fun of for it, but I obviously didn't care. I played soccer at the age of 5, and I haven't looked back since. Soccer, well, sports in general, takes a lot of commitment that most people don't have. I'd like to thank my father for instilling and giving me the traits of hard work and dedication. And thanks to him, I've accomplished a lot in my, I guess you can say, career. Don't get me wrong, I'm fully aware that my chances of going professional are very slim and that it probably won't happen. I don't know if I will ever make it professionally, but one thing I know for sure, and one thing that will always stick with me, are the memories that soccer has given me throughout these years. The struggles, the victories, and the friendships will never be forgotten. If soccer has taught me anything, it is that with hard work, anything is possible on the field. As my years of playing soccer wind down, I will continue to work hard and play hard. In every single game, and hopefully I'll reach my goal of committing to a college, and then from there I'll try to reach the ultimate goal.
All the glitter
is my goal.
Yeah, we gonna cook this up.
Reality.
That's a new girlfriend.
This is family business, and this is for the family that can't be with us.
All right. So if you guys fell asleep during my video, walked out at any point during the video, or covered your ears and eyes at any point in the video, let me give you a quick summary. of what it consisted of. So my life has been all about hard work for everything that I wanted. I will work hard to get my grades up. I will work hard to graduate high school, and I will work hard to become the first Ortiz that finishes college. Working hard isn't a choice, it's going to be my lifestyle. I will make sure that I leave no goals pending and that I try to accomplish everything that I have set for the future. My friends, my family, and the beautiful sport of soccer have taught me that with hard work and love, you can get anywhere you want to go and you can achieve a lot of things. They have inspired me and helped me to become a better person each and every single day. And yeah, that was basically my message. So I hope you guys enjoyed my last lecture video, and hopefully you learned at least one thing from watching the video. So yeah.